make progress in these talks starting next week, but I don't think we're going to see any breakthroughs next week. We're going to listen to their concerns, they'll listen to our concerns, and we'll see if there are grounds for progress. But to make actual progress, it's very hard to see that happening when there's an ongoing escalation, when Russia has a gun to the head of Ukraine with 100,000 troops near its borders, the possibility of doubling that on very short order. So if we're seeing de-escalation, if we're seeing a reduction in tensions, that is the kind of environment in which we could make real progress. And again, address concerns, reasonable concerns on both sides.
Now, David B. Des Roches is a professor at the National Defense University. He joins me now live from Washington, D.C. Professor, thank you very much for joining us here on TRT World. Now, Russia appears to be very pessimistic about these talks. Now, tell me, if these talks between Russia and the United States fail, is an all-out war between Ukraine and Russia imminent?
I don't think so. I don't think that an all-out war is ever really in the cards. What is possible is a continuation of the seven-year war from when Russia initially invaded Ukraine. I think that the most likely scenario is that we'd probably see an attempt to build a land bridge between the Donbas, where you have Russian forces together with Russian-controlled local rebels, to the Crimea, which was just seized and annexed by Russia. But I don't think that Russia will be so brazen as to try to, you know, seize Kiev or, you know, to suck up the entire country. That would just be too complicated for them.
Okay, then, Professor, what do you think would be the potential outcome of these talks?
Honestly, I don't expect much. I think it'll be what diplomats call a frank exchange of views. I mean, this crisis has been precipitated by Russia massing forces on the border of Ukraine and positioning itself to complete the war that it started in 7 years ago. What Russia has demanded, quite frankly, is not really related to Ukraine and is kind of divorced from reality. They're basically calling for the reestablishment of a sphere of influence like the former Soviet Union had. I don't think that anybody in the West can agree to those conditions. So I think what you'll have is a frank exchange of views and then probably another round of negotiations that will produce some sort of face-saving agreement that, quite frankly, I don't think anybody has much confidence in. I'm not very sanguine about this.
So, as I understand, Professor, unless both sides, and by both sides I mean the United States and Russia, make concessions, there could be no breakthrough.
No, I'm not saying that. The concessions that Russia has asked for are inconceivable, and they're not in the United States' ability to deliver. You know, they're calling for things like NATO to withdraw from countries that were part of the Warsaw Pact. Those countries will not agree to that, and NATO takes action on consensus. So, you know, this is, and Russia knows that. So I think this is really political theater for Putin because, you know, he poses himself as a strong man. He's got an economy that's in decline. And 7 years onward, he still has been unable to incorporate the Ukraine or the parts of the Ukraine that he initially invaded into Russia. That's really what this is about. And focusing on the issues on the table is a little bit of a distraction.
Right. Now, Professor, before I let you go.
Sure.
If these talks fail, what could be the likely impact on the region?
Well, good question. So I don't think there'll be, you know, the region is already pretty tense, pretty everybody's nervous. I think what we'll probably see is that initial Russian actions will probably be aimed towards Western Europe. And I think that there'll probably be some issues with the exports of natural gas to Western Europe. And then conversely, I think that we'll see also economic pressure being put on Russia from the West. I'm not sure how effective either of those will be, but I don't think that we'll see an immediate military reaction.
All right, Professor David Des Roches, thank you very much for talking to us here on TRT World. As always, we really appreciate your analysis.
Thank you.